There's a white ship in the northern sea. Is it a warship? Asked the prince. It doesn't appear to be armed. It's coming up to the castle. It looks like they're trying to come alongside the pier. It's probably my friend's ship, says McBain. Don't worry, I'll go with you. It might be, but we don't know that. Is that a cannon? Or a huge telescope? Periscope? Whatever. Hey, it's Jan and Rick! Bring our dog back, please. Thomas. Captain Thomas says, hey, Forte, Avin. We've been waiting for you, says Forte. Oh, Grandpa Lap. Mitchell, how do you do? I'm Mitchell, a friend of Mr. McBain and the others over there. Please forgive me for visiting you all of a sudden. I guess we don't introduce, he has to introduce himself. I can use as many comrades as possible, says the prince. I'd be happy to welcome Mr. McBain's fellows. Thank you very much, says Mitchell. Avin says, I've asked him to do some research about the Dark Sun. What did you find? As you expected, Mitchell says, the key is the resonance spells and the vessel, which should be somewhere in this castle. Dual says, do you know about the vessel? Yeah, more or less. Why don't we sit down and talk? Let's go inside the castle. This way, please. Mitchell says, some of the documents and folklores passed down in Weltluna have references to the Water Tribe. Yeah, says McBain. Some are for children's readings, and some are documents about historical research. I know that too, says Forte. I know only from the stories for children, though. Una says, the story goes like this. A long time ago, people gained prosperity by using spells, but they misused the spells and summoned archenemy. As a result, the world is very close to being destroyed. Isn't that right? But the world was saved, right? Asked Forte. Oh, you're in it. Some books say that the Water Tribe sealed archenemy with the lost memory. That's right, says Mitchell. We could imagine that the water melody would be effective if the story were true. That's why we have collected the resonance stone, says McBain. Forte says, we found out that the water melody reproduced by Leon had the same effect even though the original one had been lost. Mitchell says, in fact, we went to meet the people of the hidden village Shulf to confirm several things. We thought we might be able to find clues by researching what happened to the water tribe, since it disappeared from history. How did it go? Asked Avin. We heard some interesting stories. The Water Tribe seemed to largely have three different roles, which are Skill, Vessel, and Karma. Skill refers to the resonance spells of Shulf. That is, it means Arya's existence. Arya's existence? And they told us that the Vessel means the facility of Water Tribe left here in Buridan. Or should we call it a ruin? Ruin, says Forte. Is that the ruin which is said to have been used for sealing? You know well, don't you? Says the prince. We call the ruin Viola Room. Oh, I've been in there. Viola Room? Does it still exist? Asked Mile. Yeah, it's located below the castle's basement. I've never confirmed with my own eyes, but the existence of Vessel has been known from the ancient time. I heard Viola Room was incomplete at the time when it had sealed the evil power, says McBain. Prince says, after the evil power was sealed, the Water Tribe remaining here completed it because they were desperate about the threat of the Dark Sun. But no other information was passed down to Buridan. We only have Vessel passed down. Here is another possibility, says Mitchell. The Water Tribe went their separate way, cutting off any contact with each other, still carrying the same role they had when they sealed the evil power. Forte says, but now I know about those who inherited Skill and Vessel, but where did the people go who inherited Karma? What is Karma anyway, says Una. It means that a deed surely bears a result, Avin says. Does that mean that the result produced by sealing the evil power, says McBain. Forte says, so it could be that the people in Selbart who protected the Dark Sun? I can't say anything at this point, says Mitchell. At any rate, says Thomas, we gotta come up with a plan to destroy the Dark Sun. That's right, says Mitchell. First of all, the vessel has to emerge. You can consider Viola Room as a kind of enormous tuning fork which enhances or controls the resonance spells. All are controlled by melodies, just like the skills were back then. And the melody Mr. McBain has been looking for is the one that helps Vessel emerge, which is... Lost Melody, says Thomas. Or Water Melody, which the famous Leon Friedrich Richter carved on 24 of the resonance stones, says Mitchell. Thomas says, what we have to do is to go to the underground from here, get to Viola Room, and play the melody. But we haven't found all the resonance stones yet, says Una. Right, says Forte. We have three more to go. Time, Hermit, and Birth, says McBain. Forte says, besides, we still don't know how to put them together. Time, says the prince. Stigma, can you bring it to me? What? You guys have it? Yes, sir, says Stigma. Maybe that's something I missed. I didn't realize they actually had all the stones. Or they have one of them. Here you go. McBain says, oh, this is the Resonance Stone of Time, says the prince. Please accept it. Forte and his friends obtain the Resonance Stone of Time. The prince says, they are what my deceased father Luzark II forced Leon to make. Oh, he forced him to make it? He isolated Leon on Rect Island and forced him to create resonance stones in order to gain the water melody. Now I understand why he did such a merciless thing. He wanted the water melody in order to make Viola Room emerge. I thought that room in the basement was Viola Room. I uncovered another of his sins. How much longer will I spend redeeming his sins? McBain says, so your father knew the relationship between the melody and Viola Room. He must have. The existence of Vessel was passed down, but no one has ever seen it. But my father sent a search party many times to the underground and finally found Viola Room. He used to tell his close advisors prior to his death that the answers had been in Viola Room. Probably the right composition of the music were left there. After he died, no one had gone there because nobody knows how to open the door. Avin says, so you mean as long as we get to Viola Room, we'll be able to find out how to connect the phrases and be able to play them. How do you control it after it emerges? Asks Mile. The prince says, it should be controlled by a certain melody, but I don't know which one is appropriate. It is because there's no skill passed down in Buridan. How about Aria? Asks Una. Oh yeah, says Forte. Mitchell says, yeah, it's possible to control Viola Room and quiet Dark Sun with her singing. However, it's necessary that she should sing at the right place where Viola Room emerged in order to gain the precise resonance. And I have one more thing to confirm, which is that the Dark Sun is only a part of the sealed evil power. Forte says, I heard that they used the power of the harmful frequency taken out of the evil power because Viola Room wasn't completed. Una says, so Dark Sun is a block of the harmful frequency produced then? You're exactly right, says Mitchell. The limitation came to suppress the evil power 950 years ago, and the Water Tribe decided to say goodbye to resonance spells. Furthermore, they tried to get rid of the evil power from, quote-unquote, this world. However, being close to the completion of Viola Room, the world faced the crisis of destruction. So, they couldn't make it? Asks Mile. I guess so, says Forte. Mitchell continues, and so the Water Tribe factored out a part of the harmful frequency which consisted of the evil power and made up for the incomplete power of Viola Room. I see, says Avin. That's what happened. The important thing is that both the evil power, which was illustrated as the archenemy in folklore, and the Dark Sun, which was a part of it, used to be the same mass of harmful frequencies. Both grow by absorbing negative notions from an outside source once they become active. We don't have much time left. Forte says, and if they continue absorbing it, we'll make a huge explosion, right? Mitchell says, the explosion itself is a great threat, but the large resonance which would be caused by the explosion is going to be more of a threat. Harmful frequency, which consists of the dark sun with an impact of explosion, will create a wave by making a chain of resonances and gradually take in the entire world. I found out about the great resonance while researching, but as a matter of fact, I have a few guesses about it. What are they? Asked the prince. It's a plague of waves which appear when a civilization falls into ruin. In my country, we call it the wave of Rao Yao. Yeah, I remember that. The wave of Rao Yao? I don't even know how to say that. If the folklore is true, the world will be destroyed in a few days. Hmm, says Forte. How many hours left till dark sun is saturated and explodes? If it stays like this, it will last another 7 days. But that's a big if. For example, if the resonance spells are used near the dark sun, the chain reaction of the resonance will occur, and activity speed will go faster. If that happens, it won't last that long. It's appropriate to think we have less than 7 days. Appropriate, says Thomas. Hey, you're making me cry. Forte says, but we know what we must do, so let's carry on with that. Thomas says, we have to find the remaining two resonance stones as soon as possible. According to the document Leon left, there are 24 resonance stones in all, says McBain. Purification, mind's eye, we're going to go over them again. Life, target, love, fire, light, earth, water, wind, mirror, lullaby, bind, technique, perseverance, force, march, quagmire, hermit, darkness, time, spirit, confusion, and birth. So we need birth and one of the others. Hermit. We still have to look for the stones of hermit and birth. Let's take a look at the magic map. Let's go to the videotape. North wall. Well, I can't make it go over there, can I? Evidently, to the north. Huh? It shows only one of them, says Mitchell. Well, I figured both of them might be there. It looks like it, says McBain. Since we left La Turatudo, we've been looking for resonance stones carefully on the map. I don't think we've missed any. Mitchell says, for the time being, let's do what we can do right now. Let's start with the resonance stone that we know the location of. Besides, we don't have much time either, says Forte. Una says, there was a time when the two of them were at the same place, but we didn't notice. Either way, says Forte, we better look for the one that we know the whereabouts of. That's what he just said. Grandpa, where is the location? It's in Rect Island. Mitchell says, it's the island where Luzark II exiled Leon, right? It's highly likely, says Thomas. Okay, let's get going right away. Miles says, some of us should stay so that the defense of this castle be secured. Yeah, the prince can stay. And Thomas. Mile has to come with us, and so does Avon. Besides, we can't leave Arya alone, even though the nest of the wood soldiers have been destroyed. But they may still be around. Avon says, McBain, Forte, and Una will go for sure. They want us to ask Prince Dual to be our guide. Mr. Mitchell is needed for the research on the premise. They will go on the Planetos too, so Mr. Thomas must go. I don't want to leave Mile and Avon behind. That means we are the only ones left, says Avon. What a disappointment, says Mile. Don't say that, Avon says. Mitchell and Thomas join the party. Prince Duaro, please be careful, says Stigma. Don't worry, says Prince. Let's get going, Thomas says. Avon, Mile, hold down the castle. I do not agree. Yeah, says Avon. You can count on us, says Mile. Jan, Rick, see you later, says Una. Woof! Squeak! Forte and his friends entrusted the others to guard Grabadel Castle and headed to Rect Island aboard the Planetos 2. What? Were they right? Pranatus? The Pranatus 2? No, we gotta buy our weapons. That's not fair. We didn't buy our weapons. What an abrupt cliff, says Forte. The prince says, Rect Island, which even a bird doesn't come to. It's been about 20 years since Rect Island was closed down. So, no one's on this island now? Says Una. There should be no one on the island, says the prince. If there is, Thomas says, it's either a monster or a ghost of inmates. The prince says, the wood soldiers which my father used as a prison guard when he was a king may be still alive. So you shouldn't let your guard down. I'm sure we'll find plenty. The wood soldiers? McBain says, before numerous mass-produced? It is said that the skill was discovered at my grandfather's generation, but it has nothing to do with current Buridane. At any rate, it's strange, says Mitchell. Mitchell looked up at the sky. Why is the dark sun staying above this island? Show us. Come to think of it, says Forte, it is strange. The prince says, it must have been attracted by Leon's resonance stone. Mitchell says, then it should stay above Mr. McBain because he has 22 of them. Good point. I hope it doesn't stay above me, says McBain. Well, actually, he doesn't have all of them. Una and Forte have the others. I have one warning to tell you, says Mitchell. Regarding a battle against the wood soldiers and the monsters. You might stimulate the Dark Sun if you use the resonance spells to attack them from such a close position from it. Oh, we never do that. The attacks, more or less, are accompanied with feelings of destruction. I suggest to you not to use the resonance spells. I understand, says McBain. Okay, says Forte. I agree, says Una. Huh? Says Mitchell. What's wrong? Asks Forte. I just had a different yet strange sign of presence from the Dark Sun. I think it was just my imagination. The prince says, there should be a cave hole somewhere on the cliff. I remember getting out on the top of the cliff. From the hole through a limestone cave. Let's go. Oh, wait. Can we go back? Yeah, let's go back. Because I need to look around the... I was not really willing to go there. It just kind of, as soon as I started moving in any direction, we started climbing it. I don't want to be exiled to such a place. I'm glad that I didn't become a bad pirate. Yeah, you bad. Hi. The closed prison island. It's cold and deserted and spooky. I like it spooky. We can go in here. Whoop. Indeed, Planetos 2. This is an item shop. Is there a weapon shop? Nothing in here. Do the exchange. Wow, we got 17,411 gents. Hold on one second, I just want to see something that I had written down. The last Fred book is on this island. It says there's a chest north of an abandoned house. That's where the last one is. We could use some more restore snuff. Other than that, not much else. Hi. Isn't the Planetos 2 a pretty good ship? It's strong, cool, and fast. You wouldn't be able to find anything like this in the world. There's nothing in here. Oh, there's another stairs down. Because I think we looked around here before, but I don't remember. Please let us go. What's the note say? I want to read it. No, it's down here. Captain, take caution since we don't know what kind of monsters there may be. Don't worry, it's just a monster. Stop. It doesn't matter what kind of monsters we deal with if you can touch it. Okay. It's possible that the ghosts of the convicts who died here may appear. Ghosts? Says Thomas. Are you scared of ghosts? I'm not scared. It sounds like you're lying. I finally found something you're scared of, Captain. Get back here. You must be dealt with now. Alright. Come follow us. Yes! Alright, moon sword for Forte. I was gonna get one for Avin too, but he's not even in the party now, so moon sword. And Mile left the party. I was gonna buy his thing. Elm rod for Mitchell. Oh, Mitchell's with us too. That's right. Alright, so we got this glove. I haven't been using Una, but I might now. She might be the only healer? I didn't check out Thomas. Alright, stand by guys, I'll be right back. Alright, let's see. Okay, so Forte with the moon sword. Significant. Attack going up by 12 points. I like it. Dewall already has a moon sword. Mitchell with the elm rod going up 12 points as well. Yeah, I don't want to give him the resurrect ring, since he might leave the party. I just want to check out, yeah, we looked at Duaro, we didn't look at Mitchell and Thomas. So Elmrod and Warrior Fur. Thomas has Moon Shield, Charge Shield, and Warrior Fur. The rest of us who can have Charge Shields have Charge Shields. And yeah, that's that. Okay, so Mitchell's got healing. He's got Laprea. Heals out allies moderately. He's got Cure Paralyze and Bind. And then Black Magic, he's got Stone Blast. Launches rocks to damage one enemy. Handed down in Elfilden. Fireball, Flaming Bullets for one enemy. Shine Bullet, Shining Bullets. Oxide Ring, damages one enemy locked in a space. And then finishing moves, he's got B Ascension. A reinforced version of reincarnation. It destroys a wicked soul completely. Wow, that sounds amazing. Skill, collect magic. Refines the magic power inside the body to raise the attack power. And then transfer. The user's magic power is partially transferred to others. Oh, that's neat. That's an interesting thing. And then Thomas has Stone Blast. Aqua Rip launches water balls, Fireball, Aerial Labris, a tornado damages one enemy, Shine Bullet. Finishing moves, you got Jump Rush, we know that one. Forte has that. And I think the Prince as well. And then skills, he's got Large Wave, a strong impact that blows away the enemy. Tsunami, a strong impact that inflicts devastating damage to the enemy. And Swirl, a strong impact that inflicts damage to the surrounding enemies. Not inflects. Alright, let's sell these other things. The Fur Rod. And the Night Sword. Okay, so now we have 8511. I mean, I would buy it for Mile, but I'm not completely sure. What if he never joins the party again? So, cross a fairy bow for Una, or champ glove for McBain. And warrior fur for Una. All right, let's get the fairy bow for Una. And see if we can get her that armor as well. We'll see. Alright, so attack going up by 12, defense by 1. I'll take it. I'll take it. Selling the crossbow. Oh yeah, we can get her that armor. Warrior fur. Alright, defense going up by 8. Selling the knight armor again. Alright, so we still got that amount of money left. Maybe we'll find enough. If Mile joins, we can, back in town, we can get his, his thing. His high chakram, whatever the hell it is. Oh, and I want to do this. Okay. So we got Forte, McBain, Una, and Dwarl. Mitchell and Thomas are out for now. Okay, we're gonna go with that. And I probably will switch them back in just to check out what they're... what their style is all about. Hello? Who are you? Oh, Ruka! Sub-leader Ruka. The water flow around this area is a little strange. Is it because the continent surrounds the island? It's hard to imagine that this terrain was created naturally. I do not know. Pardon me. I don't want to go in there. Was it dark out before? There's another person over here. If you need equipment, go to the hold of the ship. We have complete selection of weapons and tools. But they are not free now. They are not free, though. Yeah, we just spent a lot of money down there. Thanks, though. Rect Island. Get wrecked. Which way are we supposed to go? Okay, that would be this way then. Look at that bird. I heard a crazy little birdie. Wait. Oh, I didn't realize we can go. I didn't realize that was. I thought that was a wall. Dead end here. Oh, we go up there as well, huh? Up we go. Coco, coco. Well, look at this column. It's hard to make my character go to the left. If anyone's wondering why I just suddenly stop sometimes. I think I need a new controller. Ah, we are here. Well, I'm gonna call in an episode here before we go inside. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.